I finally got around to wiring up the off-grid circuit to this grid tie inverter. This inverter has a neat little option. When the power goes out, when the grid goes down, a secondary dedicated off-grid circuit, you can have it kick on and it'll put out 1500 watts, up to 1500 watts at 120 volts, versus 5000 watts at 240 grid tied. So that's kind of a neat little option. So let's try it out, shall we? So here we've got a dedicated outlet. This isn't going to anything else. It's just going straight from the inverter to this outlet. Obviously it's not on. Got a little switch here. It's not on. So let's make the grid go down and we'll test it out, shall we? Okay. Oh no, the grid died. The grid went down. Well, power's zero now. Let's request this other outlet to come on. And it takes a couple of seconds to decide what happened. So it's going, oh, I guess the grid went down. When I flipped that switch, it gave it a status, a request saying, hey, go off grid, will ya? So I heard some clicking. Let's see what happens here. So, and let's see when it turns on here. Nothing yet. Give it a couple more seconds. There we go. Woo! I got power. Off-grid power. Totally off-grid without any batteries. That is really neat. So total off-grid without any batteries. Pretty cool. So here I have this induction cooktop. This is a really neat little thing. Super high energy efficient cooktop. I found a deal on Newegg. I couldn't pass it up for about 40 bucks. Got this little cooktop here, and with this, it allows me to do a little cooking or processing, bottling and things like that from the garden. You could do all that off-grid, this batteryless circuit. So let's fire it up. Now you might hear some buzzing in the phone, in this camera that I'm using. That's just the nature of these induction cooktops. They're kind of noisy for electronics. So if you hear buzzing, that's what that is. So here we are, off-grid, battery-less, pulling about 1400 and some odd watts, boiling some water here. And let's peek in here, shall we? A watch pot never boils unless it's induction, and it boils pretty quick. I'll give it another few seconds here. And 1500 watts is all this thing can do. So we're at 8 on the scale there. We're about 8 there. So it's, if I go to 9, it'll probably trip the circuit. So we'll just leave it at 8. And 1450 watts. Well, look at that. We are already boiling. Not a lot of water in there, but still. Pretty cool, eh? So we are boiling water on a kind of a cloudy day today. Off-grid, battery-less. Pretty cool, huh? Got the trickle charger for a Nissan Leaf. I'm gonna plug it in the car. Okay, that's coming on. And let's see if we can run off-grid charging an electric car. And power is coming up off-grid. And it should come up to about 1300 and some odd watts. There we go. So, the Nissan Leaf is now charging off-grid without any battery backup. Inverter off-grid is feeding the Nissan Leaf directly. So this is literally charging directly off of solar power without any battery backup, without any grid. Pretty neat, huh?